So, good evening, everyone. I hope you are not sleepy today, because it's the last talk, and the tea outside is good. If you are feeling sleepy, you can have it. And yeah, so welcome. I'm data engineer, actually software engineer, you would say, at Automatic, because I work in lots of things there. And I have worked on the Gutenberg code, which you can find on GitHub. And here is my email. Sorry, it's not here. It's the Twitter handle. You can follow me. So that's about me. And you can email me about your questions and what you want to know about Gutenberg or anything at all. So I'll talk about why Gutenberg and why it's pretty important for WordPress and the open source community. So let's move on. So why do we need the new editor? Because we had pretty fancy editor before also. So why all of a sudden we want something which is good, or maybe it's just the change of mind, or we don't know. So you need to be I need to be specific that why do we need a new editor? So here are a few reasons. Because WordPress is huge, it powers like around 28% of the whole internet. So if you have a very good editor, you can actually increase your fan base, user base, developer community, and also in open source contributions. And you can build incredible websites, because previously you would either require an expert or some sort of development agency maybe. So like now it's entirely possible for you to write good looking, visually stunning posts with the help of Gutenberg. Another is it's also the competition. So we don't want that WordPress editor lacks behind in any terms of feature, and it still is able to has a good control and is its value in open source. So this is Gutenberg, and we named it Gutenberg because in 1400s maybe in Europe there was this guy Johannes Gutenberg. He created this printing press, the first one, which was movable, so that you could create books which you can print and move around with them. So that was kind of revolution. So we think of Gutenberg in the same way, because in the WordPress and the new one, you can actually create and write posts which is visually scanning, and it kind of changes the way we write posts in WordPress. So here are the few things that you can find in Gutenberg. The main fundamental thing is blocks. That Gutenberg is completely based on the blocks. So everything is a block, even if it's image, it's a table, or any paragraph or quote, whatever you want to put, it's block. And you have placeholders, so it's incredibly easy to fill those blocks with the places. Like if you want to put heading, paragraph, or maybe list, then it's totally okay. And then you have a powerful design tool that you can also that you can try out Gutenberg on WordPress, and it helps you use it in an elegant way. You can add any type of thing you want to do in your post. Maybe it's image, paragraphs, or gallery. So then another thing is that with the Gutenberg, we have this option that you can have backer and new plugins. For example, you can write new way of plugins. For example, you can have a plugin which are block based. For example, if you want to add a contact form, then it would be a block. And this way we add a possibility that you can create new type of plugins which are block based. So if a user is adding a contact form, so you will show them the list of search options that yes, there is a new type of plugin available, which is a block you can add to the post. And it will be super easy to customize, like the post in Gutenberg editor. And you can have multiple sources also, like YouTube and Google Docs, etc. Maybe you're quicker. And the final thing which I worked on this specifically, I created this feature, it's called collaborative editing. It's similar to Google Docs, because when you own a website, it not necessarily means that the contributors are sitting in the same room contributing. But with collaborative editing, it's possible that in remote part of work, or when you are working remotely, you can actually write article and see what the user is doing. It's like similar to Google Docs, where you can do the collaboration with all the other users, and this way you can write posts. And so this is how a blog looks like. You can see the image on the top, that's a blog. Below is a paragraph, and then there is a quote, and there is a head. So the block here means that these are the granular parts of your post. You can change, modify, move around, top and bottom, sideways, wherever you want to. And that's the fundamental part of this, because blocks actually lets you write the post, which you can easily customize. It doesn't really require a lot of expertise or your time. You can just simply go with that. And this is what we call placeholders. So you can see a blog there, which is a YouTube one. You can just add a URL, embed it, and that then is done behind the scenes, and it will be visible for you. And similarly, you can just edit it visually, because here you don't really have to put previously like shortcodes, meta boxes, or your snippets. But now you can just simply put the text whichever you want to, no matter, and there are formatting options. So it's as visual we have designed it to be, so that your post always looks amazing. So this is just a small video. So this is how placeholder works. So you can just simply write and modify however you want to. And this is kind of design tool in Gutenberg that you can do. Okay, let's move on. And so when you actually create a post, it looks like this. This is a visual post with an image, and you can see two paragraphs, left and right, and there are three another paragraph in the right side that you can do. So you can see it's pretty easy to create these kind of visually scanning posts with no difficulty at all. You don't need expertise. Or you don't have to be a developer or a WordPress engineer familiar with the core and all these code snippets. It's just for the end user. So maybe you can have new type of plugins then, because we have entirely changed the editor now. So you can still have lots of new plugins. For example, say this one. You can have a contact form, and you can just, if you want to add a block, which is a contact form, let's say you are creating a contact form page on your website, and you need to have a contact form just for that page. So you can have a block, which is a contact form, and this way you can move around all sorts of plugin things, and you can still be able to control your post however you want to. And this is another chat plugin. For example, you want to have a support page, you just find a block and put this chat plugin thing there. It's just as easy as that. And another thing is this multiple sources. You can embed things like YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, maybe, yeah, if you use it. And this way your post is great. So this is the one post I created in the morning. So I created that I'm speaking here, and I just embedded it within just like 10 seconds. And I added this image and then a title thing. So you can see it's good looking. It's not like, it took me 10 seconds to do it. And now move on to the new feature. It's not yet available, but I'm and the team are working on this. It's called collaborative editing. So this is an incredible feature if you think in a WordPress, because it's not yet released. We are still working on this, but it actually lets you write posts and with multiple authors. So if there are four authors and all are working in some another part of the work, and they want to contribute on this feature or maybe this post, they can do this. So this is how it looks like. So if you can see in this image, these two windows I have combined, but they don't really have to be on same computer. They are on different part of the work, but I just for this image I'm doing this. So you can see on the left side block, this yellow thing. So this means that one user is editing that block. You don't have to catch it. He's doing the changes. On the right side, you can see the red one. So that is some another user who is changing it. And this way you can see it in real time. It's not there is a lag or something. It's just a good feature. And this is how it looks like. You can also, it's not really binding it to the text. You can also put images, Instagram, your gallery. It will be visible to all the users who are collaborating in real time. This is a video I would like to show you how it works. So you can see it's completely real time. The text you write on the one side, you can see it immediately on the other. And it also lets you notify the user color. So you can see this red thing is some another user. So if there are more than two, then you can identify who is editing what part. So I think then it's an image that is also visible. So let's move on to Gutenberg in depth. That's Uncle Screws, by the way. And so so this Gutenberg is not really just a fancy editor. We also have advanced features. For in future, we also move on to the better, more visual editor. So it's like another computer, maybe Squarespace, Wix, whatever. You can still have good looking design tool, and it will be super easy to edit your post, change it, and with collaborative editing, it's entirely possible to do it remotely. Then we have global blocks. You can save your blocks, and you can just save, let's say, your favorite Instagram or gallery to a block, and you can reuse it in any other post you want to. These all the features that I'm telling you are planned, and they are not in beta, so you may not be able to try it. Another thing is we are using modern technologies, like we are not just stuck with the legacy code. We are using modern one, React, Node.js, and this ECMAScript 6, which is the newer version of JavaScript. And it also lets you use modern developer tools, which will help you to write good code and good plugins that will work scalably on modern browsers. So we are just not stuck with the legacy. We are also moving along with the work for the web, this plugin developments. The last thing is granularity in blocks. So this means that your block are independent things. You can just move around them, and you can save them, you can reuse them. So this is the granularity level. It also helps us do the collaborative editing, because when you are doing the collaborative editing, it means that you are using one sort of block and you are tied to it. So this way you can actually have the modern collaborative editing, because you own that certain block. And if there are four users, there will be four blocks that you will be editing. So this is the second last slides. It's the keynotes that I told you today, which is that blocks provides much more than visualization. It's just not the way of creating visually stunning posts. It also helps you to do a lot more than that, like plugins. You saw that check one, and the collaborative editing, and reusing them. And it also opens a new opportunity for the developers and the open source community to create new type of plugins, which can reuse Gutenberg and blocks. So you can write new way of plugins, which will be further used in newer WordPress versions. And the Gutenberg code is amazingly structured. It uses all the modern ways of web development. You can contribute to it. If you are a developer, it's on GitHub. And we are open to all the pull requests, and that's it. So and we are also planning to upgrade to more advanced developer tools. If you are a developer and you don't like Visual, that's fine. You can just switch to the code editor mode and put it there. And visually tools for the users who want to write good posts in just a few seconds, maybe. And the last thing is we are adding multiple sources like Insta, Facebook, Google Docs. So these sort of things let you embed things very easily, and you don't have to waste time Googling or searching the net for finding the snippets and codes. And obviously the collaborative editing is amazing feature for this, because when you have a modern advanced editor, you all the authors on your website can contribute to your post worldwide, and you don't have to be in the same room with in front of each other. And we are open to contribution. If you want, you can just go to github.com/wordpress/Gutenberg, and you can just simply see in beta. And if you want to download and try on your WordPress admin, you can just go to the second link, and this way you can try the beta version. And that's mostly it. And thank you. If you have any questions, just ask me here or email. That's it from my side.
Thank you very much, Abhishek. So we are open to the Q&A If anybody wants to ask any questions to Abhishek, please.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hey.
Thank you for the great presentation. My name is Tony.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I heard about a pattern about React.
Mm-hmm.
Is this affect Gutenberg being rebuilt or just stick with React and why? And if you want to rebuild with what kind of framework and why? Okay, thank you.
Well, I think you know how you have heard the news then. So Matt wrote a post about not using React because of the weird Facebook license, and but eventually they moved on to MIT, so that's fair enough. So we'll still continue to use React and not move away from it. Yeah, I guess that answer. Thank you.
I kind of feel like I'm asking a university professor a kindergarten question.
No problem.
But I found out that all of the posts that I've been working on
mm-hmm.
don't show up very well on handheld devices, which most of the world uses now.
Yeah, yeah.
How do I make it so that the posts that I create on my computer are going to look good on their handhelds?
Well, the Gutenberg editor is completely responsive. So even if you are using this editor on your iPad, it will still be as responsive as other websites out there. And the post which you publish, that depends on your theme, actually. But the editor is completely responsive. It works on mobile, iPad, and those things. And if you are using package standard blocks, then it's also responsive. So we are completely thinking of that. No problem.
Yes, Hazrul has a question. He's right here. Yeah.
So back to the React thing, right? Matt has been very critical about plugins or themes that don't use GPL.
Mm-hmm.
And the fact that React is in MIT rather than GPL, doesn't that conflict his perspective anyway? I don't think you can answer for him, but what I would like to see your perspective. Number one. Number two is that what do you think of the other visual editors like Beaver Builder, Elementor, which is mm-hmm. up and coming, and how do you see them vis-a-vis Gutenberg competing with you guys?
Well, for the GPL part, I don't think I should answer that question, but okay.
So MIT is actually completely GPL compatible.
So MIT is completely GPL compatible, so having an MIT and GPL V3 is like...
And obviously the Facebook React license had a patent thing, which you can search online, that if you use this React, it kind of means that you Facebook also holds the right to use your patents, because you are using their thing, but you can't do the same with the WordPress. So it's kind of a weird license, so you can just search it online. It's related to patents and all these things. So it's just not GPL, it's just their condition and terms, which is really hard to survive in open source. And this is also the reason Apache Foundation did that, because in open source, this kind of things really is weird. Yeah, sorry, the complication and all the part, yeah. So. Obviously, we are aware of this Squarespace and all the visual editors out there. That's why we are rethinking to provide the same to our WordPress open source community. And we also are thinking of the modern features. For example, this collaborative editing, I don't think you can find in other competition. And this type of things and modern development in our platform, it will also provide you new upcoming features in Gutenberg. So as far as the competition, it just means that we have to make sure that a WordPress open source community doesn't feel like that the competition is far ahead of them. And we have to make sure that this editor is good, as good as others. And we still don't break our previous methodologies for the WordPress and open source communities. So that's the point. But apart from that, yes, these aggregators out there may be good enough, but they are not on WordPress, you know. So that's one point.
Beaver Builder is a WordPress plugin that mm-hmm. allows you to drag and drop your yeah. content and so on.
Yeah.
Right. Which has a Thrive architect. I think it's really, really powerful. Mm-hmm. Probably for at least the feature set, you might want to take a look at what mm-hmm. they do. And they are primarily focused on people creating landing pages and all this stuff, where they give a drag and drop interface mm-hmm. to build your landing pages.
Yeah.
Okay, so maybe I think whatever you said is covered and much more. So maybe at least for the feature set, mm-hmm. you might want to take a look. But as he said, okay, there are plugins which work with WordPress, not a non-WordPress solution, but with WordPress.
Yep, so I know about these plugins that you are talking about, but obviously we had to integrate with our own WordPress, and we are thinking of moving with blocks and all these things. So that is why we need to have just not from the outside support, we also need to have a good editor for the WordPress itself. But it's again the user choice. Any more questions?
Yes, I see your hand over there, the other side of the room. Yes.
Hi. I would like to hear more about your collaborative editing feature.
Mm-hmm.
If you compare your new collaborative editing capability with Google Docs, like collaborative editor, what are the new things? From user point of view, and also from the developer point of view, what kind of collaborative consistent maintenance technology is used in your collaborative editing?
Okay, so this feature actually was built by me before, and we are now thinking of adding to the Gutenberg. It's pretty comparable to Google Docs, it's same. It's as fast as, it's actually using WebRTC, which is peer-to-peer, because we understand that user install WordPress on their own servers or different type of panels, maybe GoDaddy, Plex, whatever. But the thing is that you really don't own server and you don't have access to advanced programming languages like Node.js for this support. So that is why we are thinking of using WebRTC, because you don't need support of server, and this is completely client to client. So this way, this collaborative editing will work on installed WordPress and WordPress.com. So that's the architecture, and it's again I'm working on this, and possibly in few months we'll release this out with some Gutenberg version. So it's not just stick to the WordPress.com; it's also with installed one.
So. You mentioned peer-to-peer, you don't need server.
Yeah.
So it's not the same as Google Docs, like collaborative editing systems. And do you support multiple users editing in the same block, mm-hmm. or you only support editing multiple different blocks? So you mentioned you have multiple blocks that mm-hmm. allow multiple users to work on different blocks concurrently. Do you also support people working on the same block?
So for the first question, it's the architecture is similar to Google Docs. I said peer-to-peer, it's for the installed ones. But for the WordPress.com, we have the server and we can use the same technologies, but we are also thinking of WordPress.org, which are installed. So that is why I mentioned that that you don't need to have a server for this feature. So that's your answer for the first one. The second thing is, yes, you can edit multiple blocks. You can use whatever you want to, but it acquires a lock when you do when you are editing a block. So it means that it has a granular thing, because if you are editing a block, that means no other user can edit your block, because you are owning it. And for the multiple users, yes, you can have multiple, maybe 3, 4, whatever you want to. But then more than 4, it just kind of messes up the post. But it's your choice. We are not limiting you by the number of users.
Thank you. Hello. Hey. I've downloaded Gutenberg and had a play. It was in the back end, but Gutenberg will be a front end editor.
Yeah, it's a front end editor.
And so, does that mean all the theme designers out there, theme editors, will need to rethink their product, or will they all be compatible in the new world with Gutenberg?
Yeah, we are still deciding on that, but most likely it will be compatible with the old one.
Except Divi Builder or Elementor or those sort of existing front end, they're going to have to rethink their strategies, aren't they?
Actually, it's just the HTML in the bare bone, if you think in that way. Mm-hmm. And we use grammars for parsing that. So most likely we are finding this solution. So it will be backward compatible, yes.
Okay, because those products I mentioned, I believe they use React to allow that front end sort of real time editing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
React is just for the development, but again, it's just the JavaScript and the front end part which is running. So you don't need React or Node.js on the server side. So it's just completely front end thing. Yep.
Thank you.
All right. Do we have any more questions for Abhishek? Okay. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Abhishek. Thank you very much for coming today.